something I wasn't sure if you guys would be okay with.
I'd have to, what fire chief thinks.
I don't know, I mean, how big is the fire, how that is visual?
I think bonfire, and I'm sure you're thinking, I think, you know, just one of those little round metal fire pits is honestly what it is, it's not like a big bonfire.
As long as you had a water source, I don't think I'd be opposed to it.
And we would have an adult, because it's only gonna be Friday night, so it's a Friday evening, it's Saturday all day, then you'll have, on Saturday, we'll have a charity chili cook-off going on the green space, bake sale, things for kids to do, bobbing for apples, whatnot. So the fire would just be Friday night, because we'll have music there and hay bales for folks to sit on. So the, that would just be Friday evening, and we would have adult supervision, you know, somebody monitoring it.
Is it just for a visual and heat source, not like roasting marshmallows or?
No, it's just the weather, and so we're gonna, we have five heaters we've rented from Boone rentals. And I'm just afraid that might not be enough, because it's gotten so chilly in the evening, so that's why we were thinking ambiance and would help warm things up.
Just be careful getting those hay bales too close to any open flames.
Okay.
Contingent on council approval.
What is a busker?
Those are, the musicians that open their, like, say, the guitar, and they play a guitar and sing music, and they play for kids.
Okay.
That's a busker.
Could I make one comment? I would wanna make sure that the bonfire's in compliance with our ordinances. So you will do that to make sure they burn the right material and have the right precautions.
Yeah, we need the information to make sure that's the.
Sure.
Okay, council.
Motion to approve.
Contingent on the fire chief clearing it per ordinance.
Second. Call the roll.
Stein?
Yes.
Pitts?
Yep.
Pitts?
Yes.
Stucker?
Yes.
Ray?
Yes.
Bird?
Yes.
McGinn?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, next up, C, National After School Month and Kids Club, Katie Gorman.
Hello.
Hi.
Just pass those around. You don't all need to take one, there's just some information in there about what after school programming is. October is National After School Month, so we like to, I like to come in here and just say hi. This is my second year in January, so this is my second time here, so thank you for letting me speak. Kids Club is run by YSS and in coordination with Boone Community School District. We run before school at 6:30 till school starts, and then we have an all-day summer program and when no school days are going on as well. We take kids from grade kindergarten to sixth, and our fees are based on a sliding scale. Our goal is to make the program more affordable so more families can attend. So our mission is to provide a safe, nurturing, and stimulating environment in which children are learning and growing. Research tells us that between 3 and 6 is when a lot of kids can get in trouble. So when we have, you know, this program that provides them opportunity, they're at a safe place and their parents know that they're safe. So that's what we're trying to do. This year we've been trying to get in the community a little bit more. Right now I'm talking to the Boone Humane Society to hook up with them, you know, get the kids there. We've been making doll toys, cat toys and stuff, so any community service that we can do, I'm really looking for that right now. And then this Thursday, we're having our open house event from 5:30 to 7:30. Anybody's welcome to attend. We're having taco in a bag, so you'll get fed. So if you wanna come and see what Kids Club is all about, hopefully you have a good turnout with a lot of the families. We'll have some activities for the families to do as well. So that's really all I had. Thanks for letting me speak.
Thank you.
I just want to say Katie does a great job. And my daughter goes there every day and she never wants to come home.
She doesn't.
She has a fun time. You do a great job.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yep.
Okay, next up, presentation is our annual TIF report. And you don't look like Maggie.
Yeah, where's Maggie?
There is a correction on your agenda. Hi, Larry Berger from Spear Financial. Maggie went east tonight to another city council meeting, so I volunteered to come here because I would turn to the red section. You have three outstanding general obligation bonds. This is identifying your GO bond, 2011, 2013, 2015. If you'll notice, under the 2011, we have a tick that is the interest rate it was issued at. 2013 is an extremely low interest rate of 1%, and 2015 was 1.85. Also, if you'll notice, under each area, we have each principal, we have a small line drawn. This is your call provision. This is when you can refinance, you can pay them off early, or you can pay them off after the call provision, but we have drawn the line. So if you'll notice, in next year, in 19, the 2013 bonds are callable, but I doubt if you do anything with those at a 1%, you would, that would not be wise. If you look on the right-hand column, or the second from the right column, we have your total principal at the bottom, $6,750,000. That I'll show you where that number comes in later on, and then your principal and interest. And then on the second page, you do buy down your GO bonds with some TIF revenue. And I'll show you where we get that number, some sewer revenue, some stormwater revenue, water revenue, and road use tax. And then the right-hand column on page two is the amount that you should levy, the minimum amount you should levy in the debt service fund. And for next year, we've drawn the line to $544,921. That is, again, the minimum, because you always do have delinquent taxes and you want to make sure that your debt service is full. And so that is what you will be looking at next March when you certify the budget. Stop me with any questions along the line. The next, the orange.
What's the average interest rate right now?
I'm sorry.
The interest rates right now, what are the averaging?
For a 10-year bond, about 2.5. They really haven't. The short term, with the Fed raising short term interest rates, we've seen a spike in those of about a half to 1%. But the long term have stayed down. And so when we talk 10, GO bond, you can only issue for 20 years. But about 10 years is what the average GO is issued for. And that's about has stayed around at 2.5. Excellent, still excellent interest rate, but not quite as low as the last 7 years. When it did, if you can see, got down to the ones, the 1.5s, and then 1.8s. The orange section is now your sewer section, your revenue section. This really doesn't have a lot to do with your report. We just remind you of your outstanding bonds. And so you've got a 2012, 2016. And again, the tick is a 2.39 and 2.25. That is, those are both excellent interest rates for a revenue bond, because they do carry usually a 0.5% to 1% higher than a general obligation bond. Your total principal is in the middle. You do buy these down with sewer revenues. And then you also buy these down with some TIF financing, and I'll show you how that all plays in just a second. And then the right-hand column is your property tax with revenue bonds. You do not levy any property tax, only in your TIF area to help buy those down. It all has to be generated from your fees or TIF financing. Okay? Purple section, these are your rebates. You do an excellent job with your rebates, and we summarize this. These are in the TIF area. And so we've got the Tri-West development, the TIF Senior 1, and Boulders Incorporated. In the Tri-West, if you'll notice, the rebate is at 69.1%. There is an LMI. LMI is low to moderate income. When you do something in a TIF district and it includes housing, you have to set aside low to moderate income in that district on an annual basis, or when you issue any debt against that, to benefit low to moderate income anywhere in the city. It doesn't have to stay in the TIF district. So that does have low to moderate income. Also notice on all three of these, you do have annual appropriation. What that means is annually the council has to take action to approve the rebate that you've already agreed to. If you don't have that, then if you look at the bottom, we have the, second from the right column, the total, according to the annual, appropriation, and then the total with the LMI. I'll show you on your TIF report where that comes in place also. We're just summarizing on these sheets. The next sheet now is the, yellow sheet, and these are the TIFs. So in each TIF district, you do levy some money to help out either with your rebates, your general obligation bond. So we've got the Southeast, TIF district, and this is, goes along with the 2011 general obligation, Southeast TIF district for the 2013. So what you want to do, and this goes back to your red section, the yellow bar in your red section. So you're transferring this amount of money, 177, 178, 122, back to help pay off your general obligation bond. Then the 2012 is the West Central, 2016, these are the sewer levies, as we saw in the orange sheets, how you transfer those back into the sewer. So in the 2012, the first column, we have a 9% TIF abatement, and in the 2016, we have the 44% TIF abatement that you levy in TIF taxes to help pay for those revenue bonds. And then we turn the page, we've got a Southwest TIF for the sewer bonds, and this was a refunding. And so that is only 0.8% that you transfer back. And then in the Southeast District, we have TIF levy, and we transfer that to your sewer revenue, and that is 100% abated by your TIF district. The next column is, so you transfer that. That's where I got the yellow column in the orange section. And those are the numbers that match your yellow column. And then we've got your rebate. And then the last column on this page is the amount that you certify by December 1st to the county to levy TIF taxes. So the council has to take action prior to December 1st to levy. We've drawn a line because this goes with next year's budget that you'll be working on in March. And the number for next year is 839,698. And then it does start increasing a little bit over the years. Questions? Can somebody tell how good I'm doing for Maggie?
Oh.
My review's coming.
We'll let her know.
Thank you. The green section is your debt capacity. If you will recall, you have a constitutional debt limit that is 5% of your 100% value of the city. And so this is the way we calculate it. Column two, because we're going into, or we're into FY19, you have total 100% value of $686,402,895. 5% of that is $34,320,145. The outstanding principal amount only on your GO bonds is $6,750,000. That's from the red section. You will pay $835,000. That leaves a debt capacity of $28,405,145, or 82.77% of your debt capacity. That is an excellent number. I have very few other clients that have that big of a number, so you should be very happy with that. When we first did the report, you asked us to show what 20% for an emergency would look like, and that number is $6,864,000. You can use 100% of your debt capacity, but that's, we're just showing you that you may want to leave out 20%. So that leaves you a debt capacity at the 80% level of $21,541,000, or 62.77%. You actually grew in the shadow boxes at the bottom by 7.34%. Looking ahead, we want to be conservative, so we knocked that down to 3%. And as you know, we come back faster and faster every year with this report. It seems like Chief and I were just talking about that. We will update this annually to, if your growth is higher, we can raise that a little bit just to make sure that we're conservative. Well, this goes on for two pages. You turn to the second page, actually, you have 100% of your debt capacity in 2030. If you right now don't issue any additional debt, we like to issue 23104. Personal property is 1,540. Residential is 95,398. You roll that back in the current year to 55%, 53,061. And then we have a fairly new category, and that's multi-residential. And if you know what multi-residential is, downtown is a good example. You have commercial property at the on the street level and apartments above those. Those used to be classified as commercial, all of the apartments and the commercial property. Now the assessor separates those, and all of the apartments are on multi-residential, and that is now on a rollback schedule. And as you can notice, 78% in the current year, 75 next year, 71 the following year, 67. What they are planning on is the residential, and the multi-residential will meet somewhere in the middle. I would imagine
that's what they're planning.
That's what they're planning. That's what the state's plan is. And so I would say that it will meet sometime, and then they will be locked together going forward. So your total value in taxable value in the district is $128 million. You levy in the district at $36.18. In a TIF district, you take away the debt service of the city, county, and school. You take away the educational support levy, the pebble levy, and so that leaves $36.18, or $4,666 is what you could produce. You'll notice from the schedules before, we pay general obligations of $177,859, and the other obligations, the sewer at $332, and so actually you're turning back $4,156,001. In actual dollars into the city's general fund, the county's general fund, the school's general fund, and community colleges. We're not recommending you use that because that would hurt your own general fund in levy, but we just want to let you know that you are turning back dollars out of your TIF districts going forward. This goes on for two pages. And we've updated it on both pages. Then if you'll turn to the southwest, you will notice this is, I believe this is where we have the LMI. And so we have only residential, or we have some personal of 203,000, residential of 8,597, rolled back to 4,781. So you have available 180,396. And you are only using in this levy $3,316, so you're turning back $177,000 in this district. Moving on, two pages again. West Central, column two, you have commercial of $236,000. Again, roll back to $212,000. You have residential at $4,593,000, roll back to $2,554,000. You have multi-residential of $181,826, rolled back to $143,030, for a total of $2,910,377, producing $105,305. Now this is where we are expecting more growth, and so we have some obligations outstanding. So at the end of this district, if indeed you have put some money forward, as you can see, will be $103,000 short in this district for the current year. You can levy past the end of the life of the TIF district to collect your money back that you have advanced forward. Questions? South Boone, again, you have some obligations. We have not certified any value because you want to wait, because when you certify in a commercial district or a residential has a 10-year life from the first year you certify. Commercial has a 20-year life, and so you don't want to start the time clock too soon. Again, you can carry forward, and in this case we have about $47,000 that is costing certifying the students to council, and that should be wiped out toward the end or middle, as soon as we put value in there. And the final, you probably wish I would have started with this one. Is the Northeast District, 568 commercial, 511 taxable, 98 personal, 25,958 residential, and multi-residential is 71,000. Roll back to 56, you've got 15,104 in value. You've got 546,000 available, and actually we have no requirements against this district. So we are actually turning back the whole 546,531. The report does have in there sections from the Iowa Code, 405, 404, 405, and 15A, which deals with the TIF. That did not change last year. If it changes, we will update your report and reproduce any changes in those in that code section, the Iowa Code section, and bring those to you with future reports. Any questions?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
I enjoy coming to be here with you.
You're not a good one.
And I will. I know. I'm sorry. My review is coming up, so make sure you tell her I did a good
job. I will.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, next up, Harrison Public Library Fiscal Year 2018 Annual Report, Jamie.
It would be nice to do the basement, but that's a pretty expensive.
savings on the LED on your utility bills yet?
They projected a savings annually of about $7,000, but we'll see. Any other questions?
Can you make sure there's no clouds for your next star party?
I'll try.
No, we got to see the rings of Saturn and the moons of Jupiter, and I have a seven-year-old daughter who's fascinated, so that was really fun.
Those telescopes came from that NASA out by Library, which is really nice to have. Because we're participating in year two, we will be receiving even more than we had the first year because some libraries must have dropped out. So I think we'll be receiving about 1,500 instead of what we did the previous year, so that's exciting for us.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Okay, number 24, report of standing committees. A, Policy Administration, BJ.
No report.
Public Safety, Stephen.
No report, but I think we will have a meeting on the 30th at 4 p.m. 30th at 4.
Thank you. Utility Committee, Stephen.
No report.
Economic Development Committee, Greg.
Just a real quick, you'll notice it says Retail Task Force. Almost 2017 now, we had a request from the Chamber for a Retail Task Force funding. It was for a two-phase project. It was for comprehensive. First phase was up to $15,000. The second phase was up to $35,000. And at the time, with so many things going on and all the additional stuff staff and us were doing at the time, we couldn't figure out how we could fund it. Myself, Bill, Mike Overton from the Retail Task Force, and Kurt Phillips had a meeting, and we just decided that at the time that we came to us, the city as a whole, they asked for the full funding from the city. And we had a meeting and a sit down, and we decided that there has to be multiple partners in this effort. So one thing we came up with was that we've trimmed off the second phase, we're focusing on the first phase, and our contribution from the city is only going to be $2,000. What we have found also is that the labor shed money that we have set aside is not going to be needed. That was $1,800, and we actually are almost going to pay that and use that money for this. So it's not going to cost us anything but an additional $200. The good thing about the Retail Task Force is that we're also having a partner with the Chamber. County Economic Growth is contributing funding as well, and then we're also partnering, looking for additional partnerships to help cover the cost. The city will not have any additional staff time other than we will be contributing our funding and also utility.
Address that.
Yes, our mailing list for the survey portion of it. So we've already had another meeting with ISU on it, and we'll hope to get it out here this fall for 2019. So it's not going to cost us anything in staff time, and it's just going to be a little bump and increase from the 1,800 we had set aside for labor shed to 2,000. And I see you shaking your head, Kevin. Any questions?
Can you explain the survey a little bit?
The retail survey is going to be focusing on the community and basically ask them what they want for their downtown. The initial concept was going to be, the first phase was going to be survey and data collection. The second phase was going to be visioning and everything else. The second phase is that $35,000. And at no time did we even think of that phase as this part of it because of the fact being without the data, we can't get to phase two. Phase one is going to be focusing on strictly on data collection. What do they want to see in their downtown? What do they want to see in the community? Food, restaurants, shopping. Basically, what do you want them to be? And then if it comes back with good or bad, we're going to have a survey for the community and what they want to see in the downtown, which will also help us on BDIF, hotel motel grants, and et cetera. But the key thing is that we went back and got partnerships to help us with the funding and staffing on it. So it's not going to be solely on taxpayer dollars.
I'll make a motion to approve the funds.
Second.
Call the roll.
Dick?
Yes.
Pickle?
Yes.
Tucker?
Yes.
Ray?
Yes.
Bird?
Yes.
Again?
Yes.
Guy?
Yes.
Thank you. That's all.
Thank you. One comment, though. I hate these studies. Because they're done by Iowa State, and I've been around three studies by Iowa State, and they're worthless. End of comment, no more discussion.
As a UNI alumni, I
five department reports. Building official Ed.
Thank you, Your Honor. On the agenda, we have a site plan for the Boone Family Chiropractic, 1305 Five Mile Drive. Bill, can you pull up one more?
Sure.
With the plan, it's a 4,300 square foot chiropractic office for Dr. Zach Weesbro. He's out on the south side in the Twilight facility out there. They asked initially to waive the sidewalks, which would be in the right of way along South Lynn Street to Five Mile Drive. And they also asked for a waiver on the parking on the east side, be on the right side of the plan there, which would eliminate any parking spots. Planning and Zoning Commission denied the waiver for the sidewalks, and they recommended that they would do a waiver with parking, but they wanted to solve with the 1 year completion date of the building. And with that, TNT and staff recommend approval.
Who's the general contractor? Oh, you've got too many jobs in town.
I don't have one.
What?
Any comment?
What's that?
Any comment?
I have one job.
Okay. So moved up or
second.
Call the roll.
Pippa?
Yes.
Becker?
Yes.
Ray?
Yes.
Bird?
Yes.
McGinn?
Yes.
Stein?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
The next item is just the alley vacation we have. It's in the consent agenda, the resolution is. This is an alley that previously was TNZ, was approved with TNZ, and it came to council for approval. It's moving forward with the transfer of ownership. If anybody has questions. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ed.
Finance Officer Andrea.
Yes.
City Attorney Jim.
No report.
Director of Public Works, John Ross.
A couple things, Your Honor. As many of you might have noticed already, Park Avenue, the patchwork has started on that. There's some issues with a couple of signs that coming through the park that we'll address that tomorrow. And then once that is completed, you remember the lamp pole issue we have on Second Story Street that went down and sort of impeding our sanitary sewer. That'll start the 22nd if Park Avenue is open. There'll be a detour route that we'll have. I'll get a map. I'll get it to all the media and you guys and to show the detour route. So we're going to close a couple, three blocks. We're going to do a couple patches along there also while we're doing that sanitary sewer repair. So, any questions? Thank you.
Thank you. City Engineer Dan.
Thank you, Your Honor. I have a couple of things.
You guys.
First one, in your packets is an action form for the Clinton Street Water Tower project. What we've learned is that we were unable to continue the project as we were hoping because lead paint is coming off, so we need to stop the project. In order to continue, we need to do containment. So we've got three options in this action form here. We're recommending option number two, which is basically containment. And then the spring will come in and do pressure washing and paint as we were hoping. This will last 8 to 10 years, and then hopefully, since so much of the paint is coming off, we can actually paint it again in 8 to 10 years. So this can be done using reserves, but then we can quickly repay it again after July of next year, so there won't be any debt. So that's why we're recommending option two. The additional cost is $170,000 for that. Are there any questions?
Are we delaying anything using the reserves for the next fiscal year on the project side of it?
No, I think we found money in this year's budget that we can access. We can still get all of our projects done. We can do this project in the spring and be done by next summer, so I think we're good.
So, for the reserve that we're asking for, $123,000 for this fiscal year, those will actually be budgeted in fiscal year 20 and paid back to the reserves in fiscal year 20 is the plan. The other money over and above the budget is $177,000 of revenue cash that exceeded expenses. So that would have just rolled over into the reserves at the end of the year for future projects, but we need to use it for this project. So the money will be paid back July 1st of 2019.
fiscal year 20.
So what we're going to do is we're going to do a budget amendment here to pay for the entire project here this spring in this current fiscal year. $123,000 we're going to borrow from the future. So next year when you see the water budget, you should see $123,000 more in revenue than you would expenditures to repay our cash that we're using this year.
So will not affect it.
And the committee recommended the plan, and I think it's a good plan. It's been responsible and also gets the job done. I think Dan has done a great job coming up with this plan. So.
Do you need a motion on that now, or is that in consent?
I have one quick question. I just wonder, in the spring when we come back and revisit this, is there any other question mark that might be out there? I mean, it seems to wrap up any issues that we might see, but is there anything?
There are several antennas on the tower. We're working through that, but the antennas are for the 911 communication system, so there's some balancing that happens. Obviously, need to keep that system up and running.
Mm-hmm.
So we're working through that as well. But I think we can address that.
So I'll make a motion to go ahead and approve.
Second. Call the roll.
Second?
Yes.
Ray?
Yes.
Bird?
Yes.
McGinn?
Yes.
Frank?
Yes.
Chris?
Yes.
Kipper?
Yes. Just want to say thanks for all the work you guys put on this. I know this was laborious.
Staff did a great job.
Yeah.
As usual.
Okay, number two is a professional agreement with WHKS and Company for the 2018 Sanitary Sewer Investigation Inspection Program. This goes along with the new ordinance we've targeted, roughly 10 block area that we're going to start with for some pump basin inspections. This engineering consulting company has a great deal of experience doing these inspections. They've done over 24,000 inspections throughout the Midwest, so they have a proven system that we're excited to have them help us work through this. And this would be very beneficial to us. And this is a contract for them to get started in the spring. We would work this winter on educational things, so people understand what's happening and why we're doing it. They would help us with that. We would start the inspections in the spring and work through to the summer. This would give people plenty of time to do whatever they need to do, making these connections that they need to do. And then we hope to wrap things up about a year from now and take some measurements to see what we've accomplished.
Are you and Councilman Bird been making all the videos?
I don't know yet.
We heard you were going to make one, Deputy.
Yeah,
all right. I can't even talk. How can I make a video?
I actually think that this is money well spent for what we've got, the issues that we're facing and the things that we have to do. I think this is great to get WHKS on board with. So.
Yep.
That is in the consent agenda, correct?
project.